Tools are fun, but they require a lot of maintenance. There are several important water characteristics that have to be monitored and controlled all the time so the water can stay usable and healthy. One of the most important water characteristics is the pH. What if you can have the pH readings in Home Assistant in real time, so you can have a safe and clean water during the whole season? In this video, I will show you how you can do it yourself, a smart pH sensor that can work with Home Assistant and that can help you monitor your pool or your fish tank or whatever water you wish. pH stands for potential or power of hydrogen, that is represented in a form of a scale that can be used to specify the acidity or basicity of any water-based liquid. But enough chemistry talks, let's see the requirements. The first requirement is to have a Home Assistant. For this exact project, having a Home Assistant is kind of optional, as the smart do-it-yourself pH sensor that we are going to build will have a display that will show the pH readings. If that is enough for you, you can skip the Home Assistant part entirely. But if you want to make automations based on the pH readings, for example, if the pH becomes acidic, send a notification to a phone. Then Home Assistant is a must. Also, install Home Assistant now and thank me later, as this software can be used for so many things and it is all free. I am two hands recommending it. And if you want to know more about the different official methods to get Home Assistant, please check my webinar where I'll talk exactly about that. I'll also talk about one kind of a hidden way to start Home Assistant in under 5 minutes, so you can begin experimenting almost immediately. Go to my website and register for the webinar. It is free. Next requirement are some parts that I'm going to list one by one. I bought them all from AliExpress website and I'll paste the exact links in the video description so you can get the same if you want to build the smart pH sensor. First one is the D1 Mini, which is the brain of our operation. It is an ESP8266 based board that can be connected to a computer using a micro USB cable, and a software can be installed on it. Exactly what we are going to do later in the video. Next is the actual pH value detection sensor, that is a board and a stick with a cap that can hold a liquid that is going to be measured. After that, we will need an LCD display plus I2C module. Also, 5K ohms potentiometer is needed. Some jumper wires to connect everything and some connectors or soldering iron with some basic soldering skills if you don't use connectors will be needed. And finally, a project box that will collect everything in one place is required. Of course, you can print such box if you have a 3D printer, or you can buy a ready-to-use one. And this is the style number 7 box from the links in the video description. Optionally, you also need a hot glue gun to glue everything in place. The needed parts are not so expensive. They cost me around $25 in total. But you can check the current prices in the links under the video. Now, when we saw all of the needed things, I'll try to give you as clear instructions as possible about how to connect the parts, then how to upload the ESPHome software on the pH sensor brain, that is the D1 Mini, then I'll show you how to calibrate the pH sensor, and finally, how to add everything in Home Assistant. Let's start! The first thing that I did was to cut the box a little bit, so I can fit the display and the micro USB cable. I used a Dremel tool for that, that I bought from the little stores. This tool helped me to do the job good enough, but probably there are some better and more precise ways to accomplish this task. Anyways, after that I cut one black and one red female to female jumper wires that I used as the ground and 5 volt power cables. Then I used 4 more female-to-female jumper wires to connect everything using this diagram. I soldered some of the black and red wires that didn't have a connectors due to my cuts directly to the boards. Then I powered everything and it seems that it worked. But there was no software installed on the D1 Mini to control the hardware yet. Something that I was about to change. There are several ways to install ESPHome and I covered most of them in this video of mine. So go check it out if you wish to know more. I used the ESP Around Inside Home Assistant to upload the software. The key moments here are, first, I had to connect the D1 Mini to the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome are installed, in order the device to be detected, and second, I had to copy and paste the code from this GitHub project into my ESPHome device. The only additional thing that I did was to add the display address, because I saw some errors in the logs and the display didn't want to work without this address. I also added a web server so I can connect directly to the device and see the readings there. I will put the whole code that I used in the video description. Anyways, big shout out to the author of this code. All the credits for this smart pH sensor is going to you, as well as to the introverted from my Discord server who showed me that project. So, I uploaded the ESPHome on the D1 Mini and I powered everything once again. But although I could see the pH readings in the ESPHome logs, the display was not showing anything. One more tip here about the LCD display. If it doesn't show anything, just like as in my case, and there are no errors in the ESPHome log about the display, try to adjust the brightness using the potentiometer on the back of the display. So, I calibrated this and out of the blue, I saw the pH readings on the display. But there was another problem. They were too high and they didn't change no matter what I did. Thankfully, it is possible to calibrate the pH sensor by using the potentiometer and the screws on the pH sensor board to adjust the pH readings. I used a normal mineral water that have a pH 7.7 as a starting point. After I managed to calibrate the smart pH sensor, I tested it with milk and a water with lemons and all seems great. Exactly as in my other DIY sensor videos, I have a challenge for you here as well. If you reach this point and your DIY smart pH sensor is working, share that in the comments by just type hashtag PHOwned. And I will know that you managed to do it. So me and everybody who's watching this can congratulate you about the efforts. Next step was to put everything in the case and to use some hot glue to fix the parts in place and also the cables. So I can freely carry the smart pH sensor everywhere I wish and everything inside the box will not rattle like a candy box. That until now was the hardest part of the whole project. And if some of the words and abbreviation are kind of foggy for you, I can try to help. Just go to my website and download the smart home glossary that I prepared for you. This glossary is absolutely free and it is full of simple but yet useful explanations of the smart home words that are used everywhere. Now, let's continue with the Home Assistant and smart pH sensor integration part, which is like a walk in the park after all these cables and sensors until now. In my Home Assistant, I'll press the C button on my keyboard to invoke the search bar and I'll start typing integrations and I'll select navigate integrations. And there is a 99.9% chance that your smart pH sensor will be auto-detected by Home Assistant and you see it somewhere here. If that's the case, just click configure. If that's not the case, click on add integration, type ESPHome, select it, and you will eventually find it here as well. Or you can click on this link here and set up it manually. I'll close that and I'll just click configure, submit. I could select an area here, but I'll skip this and I'll just click finish. And here it is. This is my sensor, one device, one entity. And this is the pH sensor readings in my home assistant, which is perfect. I could directly add the pH sensor to my dashboard from here, or I can go to my overview section, three dots menu, edit dashboard, add a cart. I'll search for gauge. I'll select it. And my pH sensor is already pre-selected by Home Assistant, but I'll click on this short code editor and I'll paste the following code here, which will make this gauge look more beautiful. Don't try to remember this, just get it from the video description if you like this gauge card. I'll just click save and here it is. My pH sensor is now having a beautiful card. Time to make one simple but yet useful Home Assistant pH sensor automation. For example, if the pH readings go below or above 7, send a notification. And again, I'll press the C button on my keyboard, but this time I'll start typing automations, navigate automations, create a new one, empty automation. The name of the automation will be if the pH goes above 8 or below 6.5. The trigger will be numeric state. The entity will be my pH sensor. And if the value goes above 8, and I want another trigger, I'll duplicate this one and I'll delete this above 8 and I'll type below 6.5. And I'm ready with the triggers and I'll go to the actions. The actions will be call service. The service will be persistent notification create. And the message will be my pH sensor. States pH sensor. I'll use this template to send the exact value of the sensor. And I think I'm ready. Now, if my pH becomes above 8 or below 6.5, I'll see this message. The pH becomes and the new state of the sensor. I'll click save. I forgot to close this. Sorry about that. I'll hit save. This time everything is fine. And I'll open the developer tools in a new tab. I'll go to states, set state. My entity will be my pH sensor. I'll simulate the change of this pH value to something that will trigger my automation. I'll change this, for example, to 9. And I'll click on set state. Immediately the notifications become 2. And I have this new one. The pH becomes a 9. Great! Everything is working with my smart do-it-yourself pH sensor for Home Assistant.
Thank you for watching. See you next Wednesday. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!